The following is a special presentation from Golden Bears Broadcasting, a division of SDSS Communications Technology. Welcome to the inaugural commencement of Stratford District Secondary School, home of the Golden Bears, class of 2021. We acknowledge that we are on the traditional land of the Anishinaabe peoples. We wish to recognize the long history of Indigenous peoples in Canada and show our respect to them today. We recognize their stewardship of the land. May we all live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship. Please rise if you are able and join in singing our national anthem.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command, with glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, staff, students, award donors, and of course the graduates. Welcome to our commencement this evening. My name is Kevin Mills. I am the principal of Stratford and District Secondary School. Tonight we are recognizing this unique milestone. I use the word unique to describe the following. First, to describe commencement, which is a combination of a virtual experience as well as a face-to-face component. Second, to describe events in our community. We're navigating our way through a pandemic and managing our way through a provincial lockdown. Third, to describe the learning that's taken place. Online learning has occurred, but so has face-to-face learning at the school in a very controlled setting. Lastly, to describe the grads. Each graduating class is different. Students have different viewpoints and different perspectives, all of which will be communicated by the valedictorian. However, this graduating class is also unique, given that you are the first set of grads to come from SDSS. Earlier today, grads along with their parents had the opportunity to pick up their diplomas and awards, as well as take pictures. Following my address, Mr. Layla and Mr. Promain will bring greetings, along with one of the school trustees, Ms. Basuti. After these speeches, the name and where possible pictures of each graduate will be displayed on the screen, along with any awards that he or she is receiving. You will also hear from Mrs. Ritzma, as she introduces Chris Rouse, our valedictorian. Lastly, Mrs. Ignor will close off the ceremony. I want to draw your attention to the program. The program was included in the grad package earlier today and is also available on the SDSS website. The program contains a wealth of information, including the names of graduates, awards, and award donors. I want to thank and acknowledge our staff for putting this day together for the grads under the direction of Ms. Treischel. Many hours and many changes have occurred to get to this point. I also think it's important to acknowledge the generous support our school receives from Stratford community. Many bursaries will be handed out this evening to support our graduates and their future endeavors. Thank you to those businesses, organizations, and individuals for providing these opportunities for our grads. This evening is a milestone, a journey of 12 to 13 years that should be celebrated. For some, this may be the only time in your life that you are acknowledged in this fashion. For others, tonight's ceremony will represent the first of several commencements to occur in the future. Clearly, most of you would not be at this stage without the love and support of your family and friends. Clearly, most of you would not have reached this milestone without the guidance and help from your teachers and school support staff. Your education has been richer due to the support from the broader community. I hope you reach out over time to thank some of these people for their contributions. To the grads specifically, my last message to you is simple. The last year and a half has tested and built character. Part of the school experience is getting to know yourself, your strengths, your weaknesses, your level of resilience, your goals, and your wishes moving forward. Part of the school experience also involves trying to figure out where you fit into society, where you can contribute to society. Our society needs farmers, doctors, managers, and mechanics. We also need people who can think and problem solve. Our society needs electricians, bricklayers, fashion designers, and programmers. We also need people who are creative, cooperative, and can communicate. Our society needs people to fit all the jobs we know about today and all the jobs that have not been created yet. Our society needs your talents. Our society needs you. All of you have the tools to be successful in adulthood, thanks in large part to your experiences at school and your experiences within this community. The staff and school community of SDSS will always remember the contributions that you as pioneers created and established within this school. Be proud of who you are, who you'll become, your community, and the schools that helped shape you. We are proud of you. On behalf of the entire school staff, best of luck in the future. I'll turn it over now to Mr. Laidlaw. Thank you.
Congratulations on being the first graduating class from SDSS. I know that your final year has been anything but typical, and that you have needed to overcome many challenges during your final sprint to the finish line. The philosopher Eric Hoffer once said, "In times of change, the learners shall inherit the earth, while the learned shall find themselves beautifully equipped to deal with a world that no longer exists." It is my firm belief that the resilience you've demonstrated and experience you've gained during this year will serve you well in your future endeavors. Your experience in high school will not define who you are or who you will become, but it will act as a catalyst for future growth and curiosity. I know that we have not had much time for our new school community to carve out an identity or a culture to call our own. As the first graduating class, you get to decide how society perceives our school and our graduates. Please don't take this responsibility lightly, and always remember to be your true self. Thank you for allowing us to grow alongside you, celebrate your successes, support you through your challenges. Now, before I sign off, I have one question for Mr. Promain, one of our fellow administrators at SDSS. How do you think historians will describe this cohort of learners?
To the graduating class of 2021 here at Stratford District Secondary School, please accept my sincere congratulations on this important benchmark in your life. Now, in response to Mr. Laidlaw's thought-provoking question as to how your cohort will be regarded by future generations, SDSS came to life during a global pandemic, and I say this with profound admiration. Your actions and efforts, your flexibility and endurance, your understanding and compassion, and your strength and global mindfulness, all will be marveled by historians who will strive to decipher the complexities of the world in which you live now. So look around you and pay close attention, because your kids and grandkids will want the scoop, know all the details, many of which I suspect they won't believe or be able to fathom. Through it all, the golden bears bound together by building strong relationships that became the bedrock of our school. Seeing week-long classes transform over quadmesters into vibrant families, dynamic and empathetic people who had each other's backs in spite of the silence that often filled the vacant halls of our school. I will end by sending my best wishes to you as you embark upon your next adventure, one that I hope brings meaning and fulfillment to your life. We are so proud of you and will remain grateful for the many contributions that you have imparted upon the SDSS family in its inaugural year. Congratulations, graduating class of 2021 at Stratford District Secondary School.
Hello, I am School Trustee Laura Bizzuti. Thank you for inviting me to share in this special occasion. You have made it through high school. Welcome to the world of adults, young adults. I know how proud your parents are and how happy for you the teachers, educational assistants, and school staff are. Your dedication and perseverance have paid off during this unusual time. It has been at times frustrating. Sometimes you have to look for or create normal moments during extraordinary times. Just like the Toronto Maple Leafs did in the final game of the first round, they restored normality to our lives. So enjoy this virtual celebration. Remember this day and the sense of pride of your achievements that you earned. Congratulations on your accomplishments and our best wishes for your next adventure.
Emily Abel, Andrew Aikman, Annika Aykroyd Snyder, Ahmad Al-Labad, Adam Altenberg, Mason Ankman, Alex Arand, Jerrica Archer, Stefan Arivong, Noah Attinger, Lauren Beckler, Brianne Baker, Natalie Baker, Danielle Bale, Julian Ballett, Caleb Bannerman, Brock Barclay, Hunter Barnes Campbell, Dominic Bartman, Nicholas Bayer, Liam Bowerman, Nathan Bezenar, Victor Ballard, Callum Borison, Wensley Bossy, Cameron Bao, Bradley Boyles Keaton, Douglas Boyles McCormick, Ashley Brake, Emma Brenton, Gordon Britton Prescator, Danielle Brubaker, Zoran Buck, Brendan Burdett, Sierra Berger, Liam Burns, Phaedra Busick, Andrea Cabrera Morales, Lily Camden, Nathan Cardozo, Riley Carruthers, Stephanie Carruthers, Paige Chazon,
Ripley Clipperton,
Ethan Cook, Alex Corey, Devin Coulthard, Marie Cousins, Riley Cox, Jonah Creer, Justin Crowley, Camden Daigle, Matthew Danon, Madison Debus, Alexi DeLuca, Tyler Dennis, Anna Dasak, Luke DeVries, Nicholas DeWettering, Peyton Diebolt, Elizabeth Deal, Ian Dill, Zoe Jane Donaldson, Christina Doney, Hillary Dupe, Levi Doyle, Owen Descosi, Aiden Eckhart, Claire Edwards, Brandon Egley, Spencer Eight, Ian Elliott, Alexis Emerson, Sydney Faulkner, Emily Fearn, Declan Fior, Quinn Finkelstein, Rihanna Firth, Cole Fleming, Sean Foisey, Mackenzie Ford, Reed Forthuber, Zachary Freeland, Ishan Gained, Ian Garvey, Capital Gabramariam, Monica George, Samuel Gerber, Ashlyn Gilhula, Kaylee Glenfield, Emma Glore, Morgan Goffer, Haley Goforth, Ashley Gojmerick, Grayson Good, Journey Gordon, Enya Goff, Lana Gowlin, Nathan Graff, Courtney Grinestage, Madeline Grogan, Adele Greba, Kelly Guy, Stefan Habiger, Bryn Hagedorn, Cameron Hahn, Megan Haynes, Sage Harper, Cody Haynes, Madison Haynes, Dylan Heath, Caleb Heinbeck, Evan Heinbeck, Morgan Hendricks, Eric Hessel, Destiny Hickey, Brenna Higgs, Ethan Hillier, Jacob Hines, Cameron Hislop, Taylor Hodgson, Gavin Hoffman, Zachary Holden, Rowan Honeywell, Olivia Horn, Claire Howley, Ella Humphreys, David Hind, Darcy Illman, Haley Illman, Jordan Innes, Emma Ivy, Jacob Jackson, Owen Jackson,
Nathan James,
Laura Jarvis, Tanner Johns, Andrew Johnson, Emmett Johnstone, Claire Kabilawat, Bryson Kelly, Callie Kerr, Charlie Kevel, Paige Q, Aaron Kim, Justice King, Seamus Kitmer, Curtis Claver, Reese Nechtel, James Cook, Sydney Coble, Caitlin Kohler, Roma Kipfer, Anastasia Kaprizik, McKenna Kyer, Carly Laidlaw, Madison Lebold, Mitchell Leach, Alyssa Logan, Evan Lott,
Kaylin Lakovniak, Thomas McDonald, Olivia Mahoney, Dylan Manley Poole, Jackson Martin, Jacob Martin. Ella McBoyle. Nicholas McCabe. Connor McCurdy. Benjamin McDonald. Jacob McEachern. McKenna McEwen. Ellie McGregor. Liam McGregor. Rebecca McIntosh. Elena McKay. Noelle McClellan. Sarah McMillan. Samuel McNabb. Caleb McTavish Giannacavo. Lindsay McWhirter. Michelle Messerschmidt. Sean Miller. Jameson Montgomery. Cooper Moorhead. Evan Morrison. Ryan Morrison. Jacqueline Moses. Darian Mueller. Louisa Mueller. Serena Mueller. Harper Mundy. Riley Murray. Wyatt Murray. Dio Narayan. Grace Neely. Darby Neal. Alexander Nielsen. Reese Neumeister. Patrick Nguyen. Jackson Nickel. Seth Nessier. Tristan Oleksinski. Xavier Olivier. Sarah Olson. Emma O'Rourke. Man Patel. Om Patel. Sridhar Patel. Hannah Patton. Michael Pauli. Braden Poutler. Claire Perot. Emma Paff. Demi Petmongyong. Mallory Phillips. Christopher Phyllis. Annie Pimsavan. Journey Plowman. Sean Potter. Kyle Powers. Benjamin Praesuth. Ryan Pratt. Lydia Putz. Brittany Rahu. Nicole Rao. Jackson Ross. Atlas Regier. Luke Real. Maya Rock. Jaden Roddick. Joshua Rogers. Joey Rooney. Julia Rose. Allison Roth. Clara Roth. Jacob Roth. Christopher Rouse. Owen Saunders. Taralyn Schaefer. Joseph Shank. William Schlotzauer. Hannah Schmidt. Lucas Schneider. Troy Schulthes. Quentin Sebin. Lauren Segrin. Maddie Sepala. Owen Shanklin. Owen Schantz. Mila Siemens. Chase Simard. Sarah Simon.
Annika Sindwani.
Ethan Skinner. Katie Scobie. Emma Smith. Eric Smith. Grayson Snary. Talon Soper. Ethan Spayu. Aaron Spicer. Megan St. Pierre. Alexis Standen. Josiah Stanley. Max Steinacker. Carter Stock. Morgan Stock. Emma Stokey. Alex Stubbs. Brianna Subject. Aaron Sutquoglu. Teo Suzuki. Colby Schweitzer. Dirk Cybersma. Marjorie Sylvester. Adrienne Tennant. Brooke Tesmer. Hannah Thomas. Ryan Thomas. Samuel Thomas. Alicia Thompson. Joseph Thornhill. Oslyn Torvaldson. Braden Tinning. Taylor Tomasovic. Zachary Toroville. Madeline Turini. Matthew Traxel. Daily Trainer. Nolan Trainer. Lachlan Trefiak. Jonathan Tooling. Aaliyah Valdez. Dylan Vaness. Matthew Vanstone. Nicholas Gleaming. Leah Wagler. Kira Waldron. Benjamin Watson. Olivia Watts. Craig Weber. T. Roy Wernham. Jack Whitehead. Nolan White Roy. Isaac Whitaker. Chance Whitmore. Colin Wickenheiser. Cameron Wickhorst. Nicole Wilhelm. Noah Wilker. Lily Wilson. Maya Wilson. Marissa Winkle. Hannah Witchy. Alexandra Wolfgram. Michaela Woods. Isan Wu. Abdullah Zoba.
I'm Christine Ritzma, History and Green Industries teacher at SDSS, and I'm proud to introduce SDSS's first ever valedictorian, Christopher Rose. So we started September with catchphrases like unprecedented, unparalleled, unrivaled times, which was really not the anticipated script for this upcoming year. Because this was going to be the year we were going to rebrand. This was going to be the year when the school became known as SDSS Golden Bears. And this was the year our two schools would start the beginning of a legacy. Now, two lockdowns later, the fervor to build bridges and an SDSS footprint began to understandably fade. Some council presidents would have found the challenges way outweighed the possibilities. Some council presidents would have focused on their studies and prepared for post-secondary studies. This was not the excuse that Chris promoted or welcomed. Now, in his position as council president, he worked with members to start planning activities in the summer, despite knowing that the unknowns were enormous. Many of their ideas were not allowed because COVID restrictions, but that didn't deter Chris. He and council found ways to make a difference. In September, he persevered and held weekly meetings outside on picnic tables, since council couldn't meet inside the building, and when weather became inclement, they segued to Zoom meetings to connect. Later in the spring squad, Chris organized gatherings in the school cafeteria where members socially distanced to discuss and plan events. In each meeting I attended, Chris welcomed ideas exchanged by council members and provided an opportunity to prepare for school activities. His enthusiasm and positive nature made it possible to hold our Terry Fox Walk, Halloween festivities, school spirit days, Kahoot challenges, and finally initiating our very first mascot. Chris's energy just did not remain concentrated with only council. He immersed himself in other school clubs like the Eco Team and participated in a citywide environment webinar which promoted sustainability. He personally initiated a plan to reforest the front lawn of the school and also joined Ms. Stone's yearbook team to bring together the visual artifacts of this unprecedented and unparalleled year for his graduating peers. In our Green Industries class, Chris was the ultimate curious student, asking questions, taking chances, totally immersing himself in new experiences in the greenhouse, aquaponics, and courtyard labs. He truly embraced all the wonders and challenges of this class. However, I must admit his daily ritual of arriving very early to class and carefully and painstakingly arranging his desk by positioning his laptop, his homemade smoothie, his custom-made water bottle, pencil case, and phone was, well, a bit of a head-scratcher. In closing, Chris's leadership at the school can serve as a model for all of us and remind us that challenges can bring opportunities, that positive actions can outwit adversity. And I think this is a lesson for all of us to learn as we build bridges and relationships with each other in the new school year. So I encourage our inaugural class of SDSS graduates to welcome your 2020 valedictorian, Chris Rouse.
Good evening, Golden Bears, and thank you to Ms. Ritzma for introducing me. You have chosen me as your valedictorian this year, and I could not be more honored to represent the first graduating class of SDSS. Throughout our teen years, some together and some apart, we've all grown a lot. I've been lucky enough to see some of you at the start and end of this transition. Some I've only met partway through my own, and many more I've only recently gotten to know. In fact, some of you I might not even recognize without a mask. I'd like to take some time to thank our staff here at SDSS for doing such an amazing job these past years, especially this one. Thank you to our teachers for adjusting their classes to this new, strange quadmaster system. Thank you to our principals and vice principals for keeping us all up to date and informed. Thank you to our guidance counselors, educational assistants, librarians, and secretaries for keeping the school running. And a special thank you to the custodians for keeping us safe while we were in school and cleaning our classrooms so vigilantly. While I'm at it, I should be thanking the students of SDSS too. Throughout our very strange high school experience, each and every one of us have had to deal with a lot of change. I know it's a cliche to talk about change in a high school valedictorian speech, but I think it's fair to say we've been through more than most. A lot of the time it's been hard, bringing new challenges and forcing us out of the comfort zones we had created for ourselves. But despite that, your resilience, kindness, and optimism have inspired me to work harder, be kinder, and to push myself more. To talk about all the transformations we have endured, I'd like to go back to the start of grade 9, back in 2017. I remember a whirlwind of emotions starting high school. The seniors were terrifying, our workloads became way harder, and my voice always seemed to crack at the wrong time. This was our first major change, and it was a tough one. But along with that change came something great, the ability to choose our own classes. Finally, some freedom. Then, before you knew it, along came grade 10. We had figured out high school a little more, and we were beginning to gain some real confidence. We settled into our routines, started to find classes and assignments we enjoyed doing more than others, and were slightly less awkward around our crushes. That picture of ourselves 5 years from now started to take shape, and after the chaos of grade 9, things were beginning to make some sense. Then, at some point during grade 10, we learned that our schools were shutting down. Both Central and Northwestern would be gone, and a new school would be created combining both of our communities. There was a lot of speculation as to what exactly was going to happen. Nobody seemed to know for sure. All we knew was that things were going to change next year, again. And so it came, the first day of our new school. It felt like grade 9 all over again. The kids from Central didn't know where they were going. Nobody knew what was happening. We just knew how crowded the halls were and how much we needed to get to our next class. The students from Northwestern were especially welcoming to us newer students, helping us adjust and navigate the building. Despite all that change and all the challenges that came with them, I really enjoyed grade 11. We took new classes, made new friends, and by the end of that year, we were pretty certain we had this high school thing figured out. I mean, we'd had a pretty crazy 3 years. What could possibly happen that we wouldn't be prepared for? COVID. Once again, we were thrown into a state of confusion. Nobody knew what this meant for a grade 12 year. It was hard for all of us to see our friends so little, and the pandemic seemed to stretch on for an eternity, with no end in sight. To us, however, this was just another change. We were becoming used to this, used to adapting. I know this year wasn't perfect, but I was consistently inspired by my classmates and peers making the best of a bad situation. And that brings us up to the present day, to now. Ever since I was a little kid, I had dreamed that one day I would be valedictorian, that one day I would be given the honor to speak to my class at the end of our year, but I never expected it to be pre-recorded. With all that's changing and all that we're losing, it's becoming easier and easier to feel upset or hopeless. We were born into a time that can sometimes feel like it is near the end of the world. The global challenges before us seem astronomical. In the face of the climate crisis, overpopulation, and rising world tensions, sometimes we forget who we are and the power we have. When I feel hopeless, I think of a quote from J.R.R. Tolkien. So do all who live to see such times, but that is not for them to decide. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given to us. It reminds me that even though I cannot control what challenges are thrown my way, I, and I alone, have control over how I respond to them. Throughout our 4 years together, we have seen a lot of change. We've felt how hard it can be to adapt, but we've also reaped the benefits. If I wasn't forced into a new environment so often, I wouldn't be the same person. None of us would be. Being a teen is all about discovering yourself. High school is all about finding what you love. And to each person, that journey is different. Their self-discovery is all their own. We are a group that have become experts at adapting to change, but we have another one coming, the life that awaits us from this point on. So I encourage you, do what we've been doing for 4 years. Go out into the world and embrace whatever changes, whatever twists, whatever challenges, and whatever surprises come your way. We are becoming a part of the world now, and it is up to us to make it one that we want to live in. No matter what you're doing next year, no matter what the future has in store for you, I want you to remember that this is the moment to decide what to do with the time that has been given to you. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Good evening. My name is Mrs. Ignor, one of the vice principals here at Stratford District Secondary School. We have come to the time in our program where we would like to thank the numerous people who have made tonight possible and officially introduce our graduating class. Graduates, please take some time to thank the adults in your life who made this day possible. Parents and guardians, we thank you for being an out-of-school support system for our students, especially this past year when you were called on to partner in your child's education more than ever before. Thank you to the Guidance Department for chairing the Awards Committee and to the Commencement Committee for the numerous hours put into organizing this evening's celebration. And thank you to all the staff members who have assisted in our celebration walk earlier today and this evening's presentation. Special thank you to Mr. Weston for creating the commencement video. Thank you to the many businesses, organizations, and individuals for the generous awards and bursaries for our students. Our students are so lucky to have such a supportive community. Graduates, in a moment, I am going to introduce you as the first ever graduating class of Stratford District Secondary School. This is a moment you have worked so hard for. You have endured the transition from elementary to high school and then from one high school to another. Together, you have faced the challenge of learning through a pandemic for over a year, and you have done it with grace. You should all be very proud of yourselves. I know we at SDSS are very proud of each and every one of you. On behalf of the staff of Stratford District Secondary School, I present to you the class of 2021. We thank you for joining us, and we wish you all the best in your future endeavors.